You can't afford to be without your vehicle. Bobby and his team of professionals at A1 Quick Oil will get you back on the road fast and with the job done right. All technicians are 100% certified. Behind Napa off Highway 51 North, give Bobby a call.
Here at A1, we don't work on cars. We fix them.
I serve on the Senate side now. It's kind of switched up for me a little bit. I still serve on Senate Agriculture, which makes sense for me being in veterinary medicine. I actually am the vice chairman of Senate Agriculture Committee on this particular term. I serve on Senate Transportation, which is a new one for me, and we've already been active on Senate Transportation Committee. We have what's called a roadshow prior to the session where we go to all parts of the state and we have public hearings or public meetings to get people to tell us what's important from their vantage point in the area in which they live. So we've had meetings up in Shreveport, Bossier City, and Alexander, Lake Charles, Lafayette. Tomorrow is our local meeting on the North Shore, which will be in St. Tammany. So we'll be visiting there, and then we have one in New Orleans and one in Baton Rouge. So that process has been ongoing from the Senate Transportation Committee. Of course, Senate Transportation Committee, you're dealing with things that, as you might expect, dealing with our ability to get from one place to another. What's important in our area? Name me one area that we need to work on in Tangipahoa Parish. If somebody says I-12, I'm going to say hallelujah, right? So I-12, it's a big deal. I mean, you look at the amount of congestion and big trucks and traffic that we have on I-12 as it comes through our parish. I'm barking as loud as I can to make sure that interstate is continuing to be widened from where it ends in Satsuma all the way over to St. Tammany Parish. It's coming. Costs of things are outrageous in today's world. To build one little bridge is incredibly expensive. We've been dealing with trying to get a new Calcasieu River Bridge in Lake Charles built. And from when I first started a couple of years ago, it went from like $1.25 billion all the way up to $2.5 billion for one bridge. And then we got the Mississippi River Bridge in Baton Rouge. As you know, if you ever try to cross that, we got major problems, right? And that's a $3.5 billion bridge in today's world. Whenever it actually gets done, who knows what it's going to cost. So Senate Transportation is a big deal for me. So Highway 22 going out to the east, I can tell you that the roundabout at school is in the works. We're going to have a roundabout at Dunson Road, Original Road, and Highway 22. That was on the books many years ago. There was an issue with the school because of a right-of-way going to a car line. And so that was drawn back out of capital outlay and sent back to the school system and said, y'all, look, y'all got to work it out to make sure that y'all are comfortable with your school, to make sure that, you know, how you want to be impacted there. They got that resolved. We got it back in the capital outlay. Actually went into what we call a safety portion of the budget, which didn't have to go all the way through the capital outlay process, and we got the funds for it. So that project is in the design phase with the roundabout at 22 Dunson Ridgel. There'll probably be, we've had a couple of public hearings already, probably another one here before too long. That issue is gonna be the first one that's gonna be built on the east side. I got some money through a preservation fund to help overlay some of Highway 22 going out to the east past the roundabout going out that way. A little bit more long-term is widening of Highway 22 on the east side like we did on the west side of town. As you know, the growth on the east side is high. With all the subdivisions that we have a school there, we have a recreational park there, and we have a high density of people that are going there. It absolutely is critical that we try to get something done on Highway 22. Man, look, if I had the key to turn the button to say it's going to happen tomorrow, it would happen tomorrow. Unfortunately, as I said, getting projects through the process in Baton Rouge is slow and cumbersome. And we just when you think you got it, something else comes up. We had a couple of projects in for Hoover Road, for widening of Hoover Road and at the interstate there with a couple roundabouts there. And it got taken out of it. After session was ended, they overextended on capital outlay money, so it's gonna go back into the process again this year. It's frustrating, man. It is really frustrating when you know you have a need in the community that you represent. But the bottom line, every community in Louisiana has needs. We have a lot of infrastructure problems. Our billions of dollars behind with our roads and bridges in the state, and that amount of money that we have to address all those is just not there. We had to prioritize, and sometimes it's frustrating to come back home and say, I didn't get it this year, but maybe next year. So I can tell you that that's a priority in Baton Rouge for us, is to get Highway 22 on the west side, on the east side, up to the standards that it needs to be. We got a problem out there on the east side that we didn't have on the west side, and that is the Tangipahoa River bridges. You got three river bridges there. Drastically increases the price of widening a roadway when you have that. But irregardless, the need is still there, and we'll continue to work on that.
Drive with confidence. From routine service to complete engine repairs, you can trust the pros at A1 Quick Oil to get you back on the road safely. Drop it off or sit and wait in customer-friendly comfort. Behind Napa off Highway 51 North, give Bobby a call.
Here at A1, we don't work on cars. We fix them.